Ladies and gentlemen, we move on with back four tonight. So would you welcome into the cage, Kwade Ampa! Welcome into the cage, Michael Coombs. Lightweight amateur mixed martial arts over three 3-minute rounds of action, and your warriors in the cage in the red corner. He weighed in at 69.6k and represents Batcave MMA, Kwade Ampa. And in the blue corner, he weighed in at 69.9k, represents Powerhouse MMA, Michael Coombs. Your referee, Mr. Sam Amidi.
Lightweight amateur MMA action from Kwade Ampa from Batcave MMA in the red corner versus Michael Coombs in the blue corner, and they get at it straight away, trading toe-to-toe.
And it's Coombs that looks for the takedown there, but Ampa's having none of it, Dean.
Very good hips does Ampa. Trains hard. Oh! Big right hand there, seemed to rock Coombs, but he comes back with a takedown attempt.
I think that was a direct response to that right hand, Dean. They've wasted no time whatsoever here in getting down to it.
Hey! Attempted hip toss there, but not fruitful. Ampa has just got amazing dexterity on his feet.
Dexterity was the term I was going to use as well, Dean. Superb there. And what a start to this round.
Oh! It's all action in this fight thus far. Michael Coombs relentless for the takedown.
Now that was incredible professional commentating. Both of us went, ooh, because that was a huge knee attempt from Ampa that just missed Coombs. And we were reflecting what the crowd were also thinking. That knee could have ended this right there, but it didn't. An incredible start.
Get a time to recover from the low blow. Unintentional, of course, but these things happen in such flurries.
And Dean, we got caught up in the flow as well, because it's a wild start to this one. Both men with their opportunities, and that knee, when everybody in the auditorium went, ooh, was so close to finishing this bout. But luckily for us, it's still on. Two exciting young fighters here.
Just a testament to the matchmaking here in the LFC. They're always such exciting fights, edge of your seat sort of stuff.
Oh, superb matchmaking by our promoter, Mr. Leo Alderman. And here they go again. It's that right hand of Amper that forces Coombs to look for the takedowns again. But Amper's having none of it. Right to the body. Oh, spinning kick from Amper again. Everything here.
Amper's just got such strong hips. He's able to force his hips backwards there. You see that? He's looking for the underhook. And he'll move his hips away. Now he's turned Coombs onto the cage.
Well, you
excellent
can see
wrestling.
He's really keen to keep it upright, Dean, because he's doing so well. And we can see how desperate Michael Coombs is to get this to ground.
Very difficult against such an athletic guy in Amper. Coombs needs to try and turn his opponent straight round to the cage. As I say that, he does that. He needs to try and get sucked down and use the cage to his advantage and bump the hips off the cage as Amper drives him back. Eats a knee from Coombs.
Well, it's a good knee, but after the knee, Coombs had to take a right and left from Amper. Both had their moments here. Most of it upright because Amper refuses to go to canvas.
Amper quite confident there with his hands down on the outside. Uppercut attempt there by Coombs.
Well, the one thing I will say in Coombs' favour is, because he's so confident, Amper does leave himself open. There Amper, is opportunity there.
Just as Amper was throwing there, it's really interesting to watch, because Coombs sensed that perfect timing, and I would say that was a great shot, but he still didn't get the fight to the ground, which just shows that Amper has been working diligently on his wrestling.
Yes, it's been a superb battle back and forth. And we were saying earlier about the matchmaking, this testament to it.
Both fighters separate here from inactivity against the cage.
And 10 seconds left of an intriguing opening round.
Oi, nice kick. Wow.
Well, Dean, the thing is, Coombs could not get Amper to the canvas. And for the first third, maybe even half of that round, Amper looked so dominant. But I felt upright, Coombs started to grow in confidence himself, which you noted late in the round.
Certainly went in for those takedowns, but again, what we talked about before, in previous fights this evening thus far, he needs to mask his shots with strikes. He can't just shoot on the outside, because Amper has already shown he's got superior hips and he's not afraid to use them.
And Dean, as we approach round two, the other thing I want to say about Kwade Amper is I get the feeling you don't know what's going to come next with this young man. He is unorthodox as well.
I love the way he puts his hands down to ooze confidence, and that might be to draw Coombs in so he can land that decisive shot.
Well, a little right to the body from Coombs and a nice left. As I said, Amper, that hands down technique does leave you open, so a low kick in reply, goes for it again. And now a shake of the hips from Coombs. As I said, he grew in confidence at the end of that first round.
Coombs winding up the shots, thrown from his hip, but he hurts. Oh my goodness, a nice head movement there from Amper.
Well, he's been caught with the left and right. And what I love about this bout is either man can be tagged. They could both be hurt, as you saw there. Amper now with the double and triple right hand, forcing Coombs for the shoot. And finally gets where he needs to be.
This is an arm in guillotine. It's hard to finish. But if he gets the right leverage, Malcolm, if he turns his arm like a clock, his right arm like a clock towards his left ear, he could obtain his submission. It looks very deep.
And it was from the moment that Coombs finally got the takedown. But before that, it was because of a barrage of punches from both men. Coombs had his success, but Amper then, three right hooks in a row to the chin, forced Coombs to finally bring the takedown attempt.
Coombs seems like to be in trouble now. He's looking to push the arm out. He pops his head out nice. I was about to say he needs to defend his neck. Oh my goodness, Amper switching to the armbar. Coombs senses that and squares his hips off. Excellent work.
Yes, Coombs has got good position now. If he can posture up for some real ground and pound. This one, the twists and turns here, superb. Last 10 seconds again.
Coombs looking to do damage. He's got to be careful of driving his head like that. Opens himself up to sweeps and submissions. Needs to force his hips out and rain down shots.
Well, he was looking there to trap the right arm of Amper, but I think you find he's going to run out of time. And Dean, these two have given us so much to talk about. We said Coombs grew in confidence, and that showed in the punch exchange that led to the takedown.
Not afraid to trade on the feet, even though despite being hurt again by the right hands of Ampa.
But Ampa is open when he throws, and that's what makes this one so exciting. And that's why Coombs is happy to stay in the pocket with him. You feel that either one of these men could go down from a really clean shot.
Ampa pressing up against the cage. Coombs looking for that hip throw takedown, nearly got taken down himself. It's the trouble with that hip throw. A lot of people can throw that in MMA, but if you square your hips off and your opponent defends with his arm, squares his hips back, he can throw you on your back. Looking for the outside trip is Ampa.
Yes, it's been a frantic pace from both of them, and they slow down for the first time. And there's the trip this time, though, from Coombs, and you can listen to the fans respond to that, and he's gone for the arm hit.
Going for the triangle here. He missed the mount, unfortunately, and he slips out the triangle. Ampa, with superb BJJ defense skills, pops his head out there, and now he's on top.
Wow. That just summed up that last 10 seconds, this round overall. Twice, Coombs got the takedowns he wanted, yet ended up in trouble. Ampa got the striking he wanted and got caught. It's been that sort of bout between these two men.
Back and forth, absolute war. I just noticed Coombs limping there as he went back into his corner. Could have damaged his foot or his knee. That could play dividends in the striking battles, man.
So, Dean, the third and final round, and the crowd at fever pitch here, because quite literally, this one could go either way.
Very exciting thus far, but I'm just concerned about Coombs. He's limping on that right leg. It looks like he's damaged his ankle. If he's too telltale with that, Ampa could take advantage of that.
Yes, you're right.
Up.
He's very flat, Dean. As you said, flat footed. It's quite clear now. Well spotted.
Coombs on the outside, looking to gauge that distance for the takedown. And imagine if he's got a bad foot. Doesn't want to be stood up too long.
And there goes from the right to the body, yeah. Looking, as you said. But Ampa, a slow start for him to this third round.
Ampa taking his time. Being more precise with his strikes now. Looking for that front knee kick.
He's been told about that right leg, Dean. There's no doubt about this. He's targeting it now. Look, takes a left hand in reply, but targeting that leg of Coombs.
Coombs needs to start thinking about checking these kicks and countering off them. Keep Ampa guessing. Oh, that stunned him. That was a right hand from Ampa. Stunned Coombs there.
And he takes one back, and then a left from Coombs.
It's tit for tat. Nice slip there by Coombs. A bit of head movement now. It's exactly what he needs.
Well, the reason they're both landing is neither's worried about defense. When Ampa gets hit, he looks to throw back rather than tuck up and regroup. He just looks to, and he's taken another one on the chin.
Swinging for the fences is Coombs. He's got to be careful for those return shots. In these exchanges, somebody will get caught and they could go down. You need to keep his hands up. Oh,
as you said that, it's the right leg from Ampa out of nowhere.
Massive head kick.
Listen to the crowd's response. Coombs hanging on for dear life.
Sensing the danger. Going for the takedown. He's got to be careful of that head. He left that head out last time and got caught in the Armin guillotine. I think the Armin saved him. If Ampa... Oh, he finally gets the takedown. Let's see if he advances. Beautiful, straight to mount.
Superb recovery, Dean, from Coombs after an incredible kick.
Ampa going for the leg lock here. Did a great job of getting his knees in there. I don't believe that's the bad leg. I think it might have been the right leg that was
You're
bad.
Right, it was the right leg. And they just look at each other, and then Coombs is still stunned, I feel, from that kick. And Ampa looking to rain blows with the right hand. A surreal moment there where Coombs just looked at Ampa, and Ampa thought, I'm still allowed to go here.
I think he thought Coombs would stand up, but Coombs, too complacent. You never stop fighting until the referee says so. And he's paying for it now, being on the bottom. He could be using this opportunity just to catch his breath.
Ampa is tired as well here. He walked around Coombs to lay this right hand down.
Ampa certainly hasn't got the same viciousness in his punches. The tenacity is still there, but the power is just lacking. He could be a bit tired. Get a stand up here.
Looks to his corner. Coombs, you say get the stand up. He had a job to get up here. And that right leg kick, he throws his own right hand.
I love the way he almost played possum there, Malcolm. Oi! Big aerial kicks there from Ampa.
Oh, and the right hands each, back and forward. Wow, what a bout, Dean. What a bout.
The crowd are absolutely going crazy here. We didn't even hear the bell, the horn sound for the end of that round. Lucky the ref is on the ball. He heard it. Sam Amedio, as always, on the ball. Jumped in to stop that crazy fight, Malcolm.
Dean, you know when we say that old cliche, they left everything in the cage. You saw that for real here. You looked at Ampa looking at his corner going, when's that bell going to go? Coombs didn't know where he was. Incredible stuff.
Grady Amber and Michael Coombs go an absolute war. Both fighters showing their tires, but this one is going to have to go to the decision with the judges. We'll be back with the result.
Ladies and gentlemen, a three-round war. Let's hear it for both these men. But we do have a unanimous decision. Our judges in favour of the red corner, Quade Ampa.
Yeah, this is that CB shit.